There was one point in time, my father's customer was in the queue. He say, see, people are cutting for 10 minutes, you know, you're taking half an hour. People call you stupid, you don't know how to run your business. But I don't go with the wrong flow. I go with my own flow. What makes you to say we are slow? You want a haircut, right? But within the haircut, I did a lot of massage, and you fall asleep, you wake up with a hot towel, with a cologne, with a massage. That one is the way we do. So, who is stupid? I'm a Selvam, and I'm the fourth generation at Lucky Star Hairdressing Salon. This was taken the old BTO Plaza, the market, whereby now the current MRT station. Yeah, that's where the shop was. I was not born, so yeah. My childhood, I spent about 11 years back in India. Then my parents, they decided to come to Singapore. Do I have option at that age? You know, you just imagine. That's the first time I bought a flight. So the first ambition, I want to be in the aircraft side as an aircraft engineer. Because you can fly around. You're like a bird, fly in the sky. But after NS, I had to go for a major surgery on my lower back. Then I was thinking, I'm a fit guy, but I have a major surgery. I will not able to do as a mechanical engineer. So what should I do? So I come in, I see my father's working, and I can't do anything, right? Because I don't know anything. So it's like, I'm just waiting for my father to finish the work. So I thought, hey, am I useless? You had to do your job. Whereby there could be some lifting or this, which I can't do. But I can't give an excuse every time. Hey, I got surgery, I can't do this, I can't do that. So I think, okay, let me get a skill. My father say, you use the razor, sharper, use the blade, shave yourself, and then you come back without a cut. Then I will allow you to do with my customer. Even my father's workers, they challenged me, you're not going to make it. I say, you want to challenge me? I take it seriously, okay. Every day I come in earlier. If I think that I can't do properly, then I ask my father to correct. Then I try to do. And the days pass, weeks pass, months pass. And the co-workers, they get a shock. Wow, this guy can do, huh? When they come, they just have to sit. So I want the customer to be 99% satisfaction. You need to be honest, right? It's not just the money. When next time they come, they feel, hey, I want Selvam to serve me. That's 100%. In 2015, I had a call. So-and-so called me and say, are you joking? Are you sure or not? I said, yeah, sure. Then I told my father, I say, it's your turn, it's your time. I say, huh? I took a breakfast. Then I walk, I take a deep breath. there was a Guruka asked me, stop, you are? I'm here for Mr. Lee. I'm here for a haircut. Are you sure? Yeah. Yeah, I went for a check. Then the Guruka also smiled. I'm working here 35 years. I have not seen him personally. But you are here to see. You are very lucky. That give me even more. Wow, my body was shaking already. I say, okay lah. I mean, I'm already here. So went in. He was looking at me in the mirror, very sharp. His tone, just a few words, very strong, bold. Wow, that moment, I will never get back. Never. If I were to be an engineer, I could have earned a monthly fixed salary, but how many engineer or how many leaders had a chance, leaders, country's leader, to have a chance to shake hands with him? No one. But I did have a chance to touch his head, which is more value. That's a God's grace.
Hey, how are you? Hey, thanks a lot. Thank you. See you.
So that chapter done, carry on. So I went back to work because of the old injury. I've been standing for too long and bent down, all kind of things. I did not taken care of my health. The muscles got a bit weakened and it's difficult for me to walk for some time. Ever since the lockdown, I don't know where to go. My parents say, you better get back to the shop. So whenever she calls, she scold me. Say, you're not like this, what happened to you? It was very difficult. And my six pack become one pack. Because I took some beers and watched TV. So my wife say, okay, you know, if you don't go, I go to the shop. I will follow you. I stay with the shop, you know. We can do it together. Maybe just do one or two customer, you know. Come back to your way of doing it. I got a customer who calls me, messaging me, Uncle Salo, when are you coming back? I miss your haircut. So that kind of statement really into me, that's motivating. So I tell myself, Selvam is not this way, you know. I'm not this way, it's not my character. I will come back, you know. I just let my body to adjust to it. As the time passes, how I expect a barber to do for me is beyond the relationship, the trust that you have, and the energy on your hands, and the thoughts, you know, in your mind. No one is above you. I mean, people can dominate because they are well off, but would you trust someone with a knife that it can take away your life? No. But you fall asleep, even though the knife is near your throat. Which profession it can come? You have no option. You have no choice. And you enjoy that touch. So that's the thing. If you're okay, then I will continue.